A big thank you to Skillshare for sponsoring today's video. So let's talk about the Tesla Model X and S refresh that currently has the rumor mill really spinning. There are quite a lot of hints that this actually might happen, or maybe even a completely new Model S or X. Then still on the topic of Tesla, they have finally decided to enter the Indian market. Awesome.
Then what? Kia to work with Apple on an electric car? Now on the topic of air taxis, we have Volocopter seeking FAA approval for a US air taxi launch and Joby Aviation wanting to go public. And lastly, Hardt Hyperloop wants to first use Hyperloops for cargo before transporting humans. A lot to talk about, so stay tuned.
So, is it happening now or not? Do we actually have a happening situation on our hands or not? So many conflicting and contradictory rumors are floating around on the topic of the Tesla Model X and S refresh. So what speaks against a refresh? Well, first of all, the Model S and X make up less and less sales percentage-wise of Tesla's total sales. Only 12 to 13% of the total output at the Fremont factory are Model S and X. And we know that in all other factories currently being built or having recently been finished, so Giga Shanghai, Giga Berlin, and Giga Texas, Tesla Model S and Model X won't be on the list. Cybertrucks, Model Ys, and Model 3s will be produced there, and maybe Tesla Semi to some extent, but no mention of Model S and X. Even more, Elon himself said during a 2019 earnings call, quote, "To be totally frank, we are continuing to make them more for sentimental reasons than anything else. They are really of minor importance to the future." Okay, so that doesn't sound so good for a refresh. However, since then 1.5 years have passed, and some new rumors are mounting that something could be brewing with Model S and X.
We remember that the production lines at the Fremont factory had been shut down from December 24th until January 11th. That already had the rumor mill spinning. But now, more recently, the YouTuber Gabe Inkel had a drone flying over the Fremont factory, filming the impressive efficiency and speed of a new gigapress that had been installed at the factory. Link in the description. But what is at least equally as interesting in that video is this here. 3 veiled cars. Why would Tesla transport 3 veiled cars around at the factory premises? Of course, many are speculating that 2 of these cars could be a Model S and X refresh, respectively. What the third one could be is really hard to say. From the shape and size, it could be a Model Y, but why would be a Model Y veiled? Quite some mysterious stuff going on there. In any case, we also know that the Model S plaid will be coming out by the end of the year, and we know pictures of a wider body-styled Model S making rounds. So we don't really know anything for sure yet, but there are good reasons to believe that the Model S and X will be updated in some way. They will most likely get a battery upgrade, with the Model S plaid of course utilizing the new 4680 cells, because else it would be hard to achieve the insane stats of the Model S plaid. And an interior refresh is also quite likely.
Now as to the exterior refresh, we have to be a bit more patient, but the fact that these cars here are veiled is already a quite promising argument hinting at the possibility. We know that Elon often changed his mind already and said things in the past, rather than later he changed his opinion. So who knows? Maybe it will happen after all. Now taste is of course subjective, but we for our part would highly welcome an updated Model S and X design. Then today on the 27th, Tesla will be holding the 2020 quarter 4 earnings call. This could of course send the stock on another rally or breakout to the upside, as you could call it. Because most likely, Tesla's financials will look really, really solid. And it's almost a done deal that Elon will report some strong revenue and profit numbers. And maybe he will even give us a new hint on the Model S and X refresh. And what about that remark? We'll show an updated Cybertruck in a month or so. What happened to that? Maybe Elon will also tell us more about the Cybertruck on the earnings call. Or at least give us a hint when we can expect to see more.
And if you want to support our YouTube channel and help us to continue talking about all kinds of disruptive technologies, then please check out our favorite online learning platform, Skillshare. Skillshare is an online learning community where millions of people come together to take the next step in their creative journey. With thousands of inspiring classes for creative and curious people on topics including programming, illustration, design, and so many more. We know that quite a few among you are into programming. So if you'd like to learn the fundamentals of code using Python, the class Coding 101 Python for Beginners might be interesting for you. In this course, Alvin Wen, PhD student at UC Berkeley, will teach you a set of useful tools, the ability to write even more useful tools, and the recognition of code's value in automating day-to-day functions. You will, for example, learn about data types, expressions, variables, functions, objects, and control logic. No prerequisite knowledge is required. All you need is a laptop, internet, and an hour of time.
The best value for money would be the annual subscription at less than $10 a month. And the first 1,000 people using our special link can even have a free trial of the Skillshare Premium membership. So be sure to use our special link, join Skillshare today, and start to learn anything you like, from home or anywhere you prefer.
Then Tesla is finally about to enter the Indian market. It will be tough because the electric car market in India is still very small, with only 5,000 out of 2.4 million cars sold in India in 2020 being electric. But that is, in our opinion, just because Tesla hasn't been there yet. Some people expect that Tesla will sell very little cars in India because of the congested roads and because the environmental friendliness supposedly isn't very strong there yet. But we disagree. Now sure, the Model 3 will be a lot more expensive in India due to all the import fees as compared to the US, because India has really high import taxes. However, we are pretty sure that at some point in the next years, Tesla will find a way to locally produce cars in India, either by building a Giga India or by some kind of partnership with an Indian car manufacturer. However they do it, it's pretty clear that sooner or later, the Indian EV market will also grow exponentially. This is only a matter of time. But it begins all with Tesla entering the Indian market. But the exponential curve is always so slow in the beginning that you don't notice it, and then BAM! Yeah, that was our very scientific explanation of how disruptive technologies grow.
In other electric car news, the Apple car seems to be back from the dead. And even more, it seems that the Apple car is going to be built by Korean carmaker Kia, a daughter of Hyundai. We remember that many years ago already, rumors were floating around that Apple was secretly working on their Apple iCar, a project codenamed Titan. Then suddenly, sources said that the project was cancelled. Now years later, reports are surfacing that the project was never really cancelled, and that Apple plans to release a self-driving electric car sometime in this decade. Some even say as late as 2027. So definitely do not hold off buying another electric car because of the Apple car. It will take a long time until the Apple car hits the market. The production site for the Apple car would be Kia's factory in Georgia. Now we don't know anything about the stats, technical details or design of the Apple car as for now. But since Apple has zero history of building anything even remotely resembling a car, we think that the approach to start a partnership with an established car maker and to have it build the car is quite smart. Especially because Kia recently revealed that they will start a gigantic EV offensive in the next years, previewing 9 new electric cars to be released in the course of the next few years. So let's be patient until hopefully we will learn more about the Apple car. And let's see if anyone will still want the iCar in 4 or 7 years. We think yes, because you will always find some Apple zealots who will just blindly buy anything from Apple.
Now on to air taxis, because we think that air taxis will be a very nice addition to the transportation mix of the future. With self-driving electric cars, air taxis and Boring Company tunnels for short range, Hyperloops for mid-range, electric VTOL supersonic jets for long range, and Starship Earth-to-Earth for super long range transport. They can all coexist in our opinion. So a lot is happening in the UAM market. For example, the German air taxi company Volocopter is seeking to get FAA permission in order to launch their Volocity eVTOL in the US. The Volocity is designed to meet the highest aircraft safety standards and features the lowest noise development in the industry, according to the company. Volocopter developed the Volocity specifically to meet growing demand for better intra-city mobility in large cities like Los Angeles, New York City, San Francisco and so on. On top, Volocopter is currently also working with the European pendant to the FAA, the EASA, on certification for commercial launch planned in the next 2 to 3 years. Another interesting company that wants to push into the new UAM market is Joby Aviation. They recently acquired Uber's Elevate air taxi branch because it seems that Uber is failing in that regard. They want to launch their air taxi service in the US in 2023, and now it seems that they want to go public through a SPAC.
A SPAC, short for Special Purpose Acquisition Company, is a shell company that raises funds in an initial public offering with the aim of acquiring a private company, which then becomes public as a result of the merging. For the company being acquired, the merger is an alternative way to go public over a traditional IPO. So Joby Aviation, we will follow your career with great interest. And lastly, a bit on Hyperloop. One of the criticisms of Hyperloop is that it might be unsafe for passenger travel, especially in the beginning. However, we all know that new technologies are always not so safe in the beginning. And then when they are established, they become a lot safer over time. This was the case with rail travel, as well as with airplane travel. It just keeps getting safer and safer. But 100 years ago, this certainly wasn't the case yet. In order to avoid that, the Dutch Hyperloop company, Hardt Hyperloop, is thinking that it might be a good idea to first establish Hyperloop routes for cargo transport before expanding the Hyperloop concept for human transportation. They are currently exploring this possibility in a coalition with the Dutch government as part of the Hyperloop development program. The first step would be establishing a cargo Hyperloop route between Amsterdam and Rotterdam.
The preconditions and effects of a Hyperloop connection for cargo between important and volume-intensive hubs between the northern and southern parts of the Netherlands are being researched. The aim is for the study to identify similar challenges and provide solutions facing urban areas elsewhere in Europe, thereby paving the way for investment in Hyperloop infrastructure across the entire continent. Such a network would make it possible to send goods across Europe in hours rather than days. Then later, when the network proves to be safe and potential engineering challenges and problems have been solved without risking any human lives, then the Hyperloop would be expanded and the expertise gained with these cargo Hyperloops would be employed to build larger human-rated Hyperloops. We have to say we really like this idea as this sounds very safe and doesn't potentially endanger any people. And on this channel we don't only talk about electric cars and disruptive technologies but also about spaceflight, and you can watch our latest videos on the latest spaceflight news here.
So thanks for watching the GIS Disruption Report, and I would say on to the future.
But what is it? Oh God im Himmel, warum kann ich nicht sprechen?
It's recording now.
Everything good.
It's recording?
It's recording. I press recording. Expensive than in the Model S. What?
You're still not satisfied, right?
No, it's good.